Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to explain how we can do valuation of multiple properties at the same time. You must have seen desktop valuation videos before. In that we perform valuation of a single property at one time. Here we are able to value a whole portfolio of 100 or 1000 or tens of thousands of properties in the same go. The first step to do that is to prepare this Excel sheet. This is a standard valuation template that we require to perform valuation of multiple properties. Here, as you can see, the columns marked in red are the bare minimum columns that a client needs to provide us. These include the full property address, so that we should be able to get the latitude and longitude from that. If you have latitude and longitude with you, it's great. If you don't have it, we can geocode the property address. After that, we need what is the type of the property. Is it an apartment or independent house or plot? If it is an apartment, we need the unit size in square feet and the type of area. If it is a carpet, super built up or built up area. If the property is independent house, then we need land size and the unit size. Or the built-up area. If it is a plot property, then we only need land size. So these are the five columns that are mandatory to do portfolio valuation. Other parameters required are the application number, which you can provide or we can generate, the loading percentage, that is a ratio of carpet to built-up area. Flat number, again, it is optional. Total number of floors, if it is an apartment. What is the floor of the unit? Is the parking chargeable? If it is chargeable, how many number of parking are there? What is the balcony or terrace size? Any additional preferential location charges applicable or not? Is the property ready or under construction? If the property is ready, then what is the age of the property in years? If the property is under construction, what is the proposed possession date of the property? These two columns are system generated. Only these many columns, around 19 columns are required. But out of those 19, only at most 5 columns are mandatory. If you have other data, the valuation will be more accurate. For example, if you have mentioned the parking data, then we are able to get what are the parking costs, and we can add that into our valuation. If you know the balcony terrace size, again we can do the costing and add that value to the final valuation. If you know the additional PLC, it is available or not, then we can add that to the valuation. So this is our backend for calculating the valuation of the property. This is written in Python, and the Excel sheet that we have seen before. I mentioned the path for the same CSV here, so it will read the data from this location. Now, what I have to do is I just have to run this program. Let's say run. Now, see, as you can see, the data has been read and the data validation has been completed and the valuation has been started. You can see the current date time, the application number, the whole property address, the DV case ID that is generated by the system, and the status of the valuation. If it is mentioned okay, it means the valuation has been done successfully. And if there is some error or by some reason it doesn't happen, then it will say some kind of error. So as you can see, the valuation is running. We have 100 properties, so it will do valuation for all the 100 properties. Now, as you can see, the 100 valuations are almost complete. The 3 valuations remaining. Okay. So, this program has given us an output here. I copy it, paste into the Excel. These columns are not required. This column F is the same column that is available here, column A, the same application number. So we can use this as a common key to join both the data. Here we have got what is the price based on top 1 comparable, top 3 comparable, top 5 comparable, top 10 comparable, and the whole catchment. So these are the average prices of top n comparables. In this case, this is the top comparable price. This is average of top 3 comparables. This is average of top 5. This is average of top 10. And this is average of the whole catchment. This price we are using to determine the final valuation of that property. Here we are adding a few more parameters as well. So for example, if there is an independent property, you will see some rate in this column. As we have taken all the apartment properties, there is no need of any rates here. So there is no land component involved. We are just multiplying the size by the rate. We got the base cost of the property. If we had data about car parking, PLC, the floor number of the property, balcony or terrace size, age of the property, then all these additions and discounts will be there. As we have not mentioned in our current template, so all these costs are zero. And in this column AO and AP, you will see the final carpet price and the level price. You can see there are 100 valuations. We have got the carpet price and sellable price along with the costs in the single Excel sheet. So this took less than 15 minutes to run. In this way, if we have a portfolio of say maybe 500 properties or 1000 properties or 5000 properties, maybe more than that, all the valuation of these properties can be done in 1 day or maybe maximum 2 days. So that's it from my side. Thank you.